Paisley Park Estate to grieve, but also to celebrate Prince's music. There are tributes across the Twin Cities area. Last night, bridges and buildings were bathed in purple. Tonight, rejection can be a powerful motivator. Just ask the kid Steve Hartman met on the road.
Every week, he set himself up for disappointment. Every week, 13-year-old Jamarian Stiles came to this community center in Boca Raton, Florida, hoping to play basketball with the other kids. And every week, he was rejected.
They'll start picking teams, and I will be the only one left out. And then they'll just tell me, just go home and stuff. You can break someone's heart like that.
The problem was obvious to everyone but Jamarian. He lost his hands and most of his arms as an infant due to a rare bacterial infection. But he insisted that was no reason to give up his hoop dreams.
What about soccer? Have you heard of that sport?
Yeah, I hear it every day.
Why don't you play soccer? That just seems like the obvious thing.
You would think that I would be good at soccer. I'm really not. I'm horrible.
Which is why, on the first day of class here at Eagles Landing Middle School, Jamarian took his case to basketball coach Darian Williams.
Yeah.
Said he wanted to be on the team this year.
I said, all great, well, just make sure you try out.
He said, okay, great, but what are you really thinking?
This man has no arms.
Yeah.
How is he going to play basketball? But man, he told me, Mr. Williams, I've never been on a team before. Even if I don't play, I just want to be on the team. And how can I say no to that?
And that's how the Eagles got their first armless basketball player. Jamarian, number two there, quickly earned a reputation as the hardest worker on the squad.
He was usually the first one in the gym, usually the last one to leave.
Still, he sat on the bench most of the season. Until last month. Coach put him in the game with about 6 minutes left. And when he eventually got the ball on the far side of the court, everyone yelled, shoot it! So he did. And sank a three-pointer. And if you didn't quite see that, don't worry, because shortly after, he got the ball again, this time on the near side, for another three-pointer. At the buzzer, Jamarian Stiles, the kid no one would pick, was now everyone's hero. Needless to say, today, Jamarian can play all he wants at the community center. He just made the volleyball team and has every intention of playing football next year. Really, the only thing he won't play is the victim.
If I could wave a magic wand right now and give you your arms back, would you want them?
No, I don't need them.
You don't need them?
No.
Who needs hands when you've got this kind of touch? Steve Hartman, on the road, in Boca Raton, Florida.
Wow, what he did doesn't show up in the box score. That's the CBS Evening News. For Scott Pelley, I'm Anthony Mason. I'll see you tomorrow on CBS This Morning, Saturday. Have a good night. Thanks for watching.